The devil ensures that we only remain with people that are where we are. And we are only so scared to move to the unknown world. Because there's nobody calling us.
That's right.
That is why you need to make sure that in your life you've got those you are surviving with.
Yes.
But you also have those who are saying, come on, come on, little girl. Because we don't belong to one level, but we belong to new levels. And if the Lord is calling us, we should not tremble or fear, because he will give us the power to survive.
Yes. Amen.
And I came to say to somebody who says, Bishop, the road is not easy for me.
Yeah.
Nobody told us that the road will be easy.
Yes.
But we don't believe that he brought us this
far
to leave us. He is not a man that he should lie. He gives his way. Tell the God, stand up where you are. Where you are down in the valley, you should rely on him. He shall not leave you nor forsake you. He is the Lord who is faithful to his way.
Hallelujah.
Sit down a moment. Thank you, my friend. I'm about to wrap. So where we reading, the Bible says, during those days, during that time, Herod the king stretched forth his hand and harassed some from the church.
Yes.
Do you hear that?
Yes.
He stretched forth his hand to harass
some.
But now it says some from the church.
Yeah.
I came to give you a name, because you've been thinking you are a woman with a lot of challenges.
Hey.
You've got a name. I came to give you a name, because you thought you're a young woman that is facing situations.
Yeah.
You've got a name.
Yes.
Your name is
Sam. Hallelujah.
The church was there.
Yeah.
Everybody was in the church.
Yes.
But it is not everybody that was harassed.
Come on now, yes.
There are always two types of people in the church.
Mm, yeah. Come on.
Those who are in situations and those who are not in situations. Thank you. I want you to follow. Say after me,
those
who are in situations,
who are in situations,
and those
who are not in situations.
And most of the times, those who are not in situations think they are holy.
Come on,
but those who are in situations.
Yes.
In your church, there are people in 2017 that have not seen the devil. From January to October, they've never seen anything from the devil. And you've been battling with the devil since the beginning of the year till now. And those who have not seen the devil think something is wrong with you. Why the devil is troubling you so much? You always talk about the devil, this, the devil, that. And not know that the devil does not harass everyone, but he harasses some.
Yes.
I don't hear you. He harassed
some.
Look at everybody. My saying,
God.
Bishop, I'm not following what you're teaching. Please define what you say. Herod in chapter 12 is typology of the devil.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
John 10 verse 10.
That's right.
The Bible says, I like the King James Version. It says, the thief cometh not but to steal, to kill, and destroy. Let's do it again. The thief cometh not. You see, look at me. The thief cometh not. You see? So if you were in a hurry and left the church when the pastor said, the thief coming, not, you will think that the thief is not coming.
Yes.
So if you left early and said, I'm late, I want to rush to my shift,
okay,
you would say, the pastor said the thief is not coming. But now the verse says, the thief coming, not, meaning it does not come, but it comes to steal, to kill, and destroy. I wanted to get that. So the thief is a determined individual.
Yeah.
He does not go without check. The thief cometh not, but he comes to steal, to kill, and destroy. So whenever you see the thief around your marriage, around your family, around your business, around your church, you should not cast the thief. You should not bind the thief. Because the thief is sending a message to you when he comes. Let's do it again. You're not following. Some of you are not catching this. The thief cometh not but to steal,
to kill, and to destroy.
So it means it does not go everywhere. So wherever he goes, he has already determined that when he is going, there's something he can steal, he can kill, he can destroy. That is why I'm saying the presence of the thief around you is a message to you that in you there are things that can destroy them, that can be destroyed. So whenever you don't see a thief around you, you should be worried that I am an empty somebody. There's nothing in me that the thief can steal. There's nothing in me that the thief will kiss. There's nothing in me that the thief can destroy. You can never say, I'm loaded. Hallelujah. How do you know that you are loaded, neighbor? Because of the presence of the thief. Because he wouldn't have come if there was nothing in me. Listen, he has come because in me there are things that he can steal, hallelujah, and kill, he can dissolve. I'm explaining the way some from the church.
Hallelujah.
So from tonight onwards, when you see somebody going through some stuff, you should go to that person and actually say, man of God, the Lord has trusted you.
Amen.
Because when you are going through some stuff, it's not because the Lord has left you.
No.
The Lord has trusted you enough to let the devil had an opportunity to harass you.
Yes.
Listen, child of God. I don't know the system around here. I'm from South Africa. In South Africa, when you are a nurse and you work from the outside clinics and you do mobile clinic, or you travel with a car, a social worker or something, you use the government vehicles.
Yes.
With the government vehicles, whether it's raining, you see your cousin in a bus stop, you cannot take your cousin in the government car at 12 o'clock noon when you took the car in the morning. You're not following what I'm teaching. It's too late for you to be able to take your cousin because it's already 12 o'clock. Because the government vehicles, they use what is called trip authority. So in the morning before you go out, you go to the supervisor's office and write the names of the people that are going to be in the car. Not following what I'm saying. So now nobody, if for somebody to be in this car, his name, her name, needs to be in the office. So is my cousin, is my blood, is my relative, but I cannot put in the car because his name or her name is not So now I cannot bring anybody in my in this vehicle if they are not known in the office. Because should an accident happen and they die in this vehicle, they are not accounted for because their name was not in the list. The only thing I can do is to give my cousin money and say, write the next pass, my cousin. Even if I'm alone in the car, I cannot help them because their name is not in the office.
Yes.